morning, one and all. Now we are going to see an application of Gauss law, that is electric field intensity due to a point charge. The charge where we have to find out electric field intensity is located on the Gaussian surface, and the charge Q is located at the origin. Now because of this charge, we have to find out the electric field intensity at point P with the help of electric flux density d bar, which is normal to the closed surface, nothing but Gaussian surface. The Gauss law can be applied only to the Gaussian surface. Now the Gauss law is psi is equals to Q. So Q is equals to closed surface integral over S d dot ds, where psi is the electric flux and Q is the charge enclosed over the surface. And the electric flux density d is equals to psi by A. We know this relation. And from this, psi is equals to d into A, where area can be represented as a closed surface integral over d dot ds. In spherical coordinate system, when the radius is constant and remaining other two components, nothing but theta and pi, are varying, the integral over S ds can be represented as integral over pi equal to 0 to 2 pi and integral over theta equal to 0 to pi r square sine theta d theta d pi. Now, as radius is constant, it is kept outside of the integral, and applying the integration to theta equal to 0 to pi sine theta and integral over 0 to 2 pi integral d pi can be represented as pi 0 to 2 pi d theta. Finally, after integration and applying the limits, the final expression can be written as 4 pi r square d. That is, Q is equals to 4 pi r square d. From this, d is equals to Q pi 4 pi r square. Since r may have any value, and since d bar is directed radially outward, d bar is equals to Q by 4 pi r square a r bar. And E bar will be equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square A r bar. This is obtained from the relation that D is equals to epsilon naught E. From this, we are obtaining electric field intensity due to a point charge at point P. Thank you.